The Italians and the Vietnamese are two different cultures from completely different parts of the world who happened to end up in the same place. But both would come to find out they weren't so different after all.
There's not a soul in sight in Columbus Square in the north end of Kansas City. All you can hear is a crackling of leaves forced across an empty street by a howling wind. But just a few blocks away, it's bustling inside Kim Long Asian Market and Restaurant. Rice noodles and sesame oil are typical buys. They're ingredients that show this is a neighborhood with an ethnic identity, and in this case, it's Vietnamese. But it wasn't always this way.
It was different. We came here in 1980. There was not a lot of Vietnamese people during that time. There was more of the Italian people.
From 1900 to 1930, this was always called Little Italy. By the media, by everybody in the city, it was just called Little Italy. And that is because it was primarily dominated by the Italians.
Local author Terrence O'Malley says by 1920, there were about 10,000 Italians crammed in the area. Those Italian immigrants opened businesses, some which still stand today, like La Sala's, at its original location on East 5th Street.
It's been family ran since 1921, so you know it's all been family. I got my cousin runs the register, my dad and me are back here, and then we got Mr. Miller, he's been here forever. We actually back in the day started the first like credit limit, like we had credit for the neighborhood. A lot of history down here.
Has been a polyglot area the entire time that it's existed.
But it wasn't long ago that a different type of business operated in the area.
The new movie, The Godfather, has already become a phenomenon. It apparently has yet to get a bad review, and during its first week in New York, it grossed almost $500,000. But in Kansas City last night, its premiere showing was before an empty house. The local Italian-American Unification Council spent $2,500 to buy up all the seats so no one could see what it said were cultural prejudices. While the movie played to no one, the association threw a benefit dance down the street.
In the 1970s, organized crime hit its peak.
The men named are described by federal agents as the who's who of organized crime in the Midwest.
With the man long known as the boss of the Kansas City mob, Nick Sevilla.
All of a sudden, the area was becoming filled with crime. You couldn't have anything that would be safe. People were not safe on the street.
John Borelli's brother, Tom, owned the popular Italian restaurant, Jenny's. Borelli says the city changed the landscape of the North End when it built a highway. He says in part to divide the neighborhood, to put a stop to the bloodshed.
That's part of the reason many Italians left this area in droves, and the other reason many second and third generation Italians went on to get their education and become successful Italian Americans. But Borelli's brother didn't want to leave the area. Rather, he wanted to revitalize it and bring in good neighbors to those who decided to stay. But the question was, with whom?
Some 15 million people with ancient culture. 95% are lowlanders of northern origin.
The Vietnam War forced Vietnamese families to flee their homes. Borelli says his brother thought, who better to help the North End than people who were going through the same fight as the Italians decades ago? But he says his brother was a businessman and needed another entity to sponsor the families, more specifically a nonprofit. He turned to the Don Bosco Center, built brick by Italian hands in the 1940s, and the Vietnamese refugees came.
What was important is that when people need a place, you know, they're willing to go where someone invites them. And in a sense, Tom's invitation of writing the grant was an invitation for families to come to Kansas City in the North End.
A part of the first Vietnamese wave to arrive with about 30 families, 63-year-old Qua Tran. Then he was in his 20s in bell-bottom jeans and had never experienced snowfall. Like many immigrants, he was completely lost.
I didn't have no relative. And I learned all my life, you know, I like to pursue the education. But I was, you know, I had to have a lot of problem in English at that time.
Tran learned English at Park University, and he'd find his bilingual skills would come in handy a little later on at this place, the Holy Rosary Catholic Church in the neighborhood. Fellow Vietnamese immigrants were already Catholic and started filling the pews on Sunday.
I noticed how many people were Vietnamese in the church, and reading the reading all in English, subdued people could not understand.
And he was invited to preach on the Sabbath.
So Father Joseph Vincentini got a Vietnamese Bible and says there was even Mass in that language where Tran himself translated. The mesh of cultures in Columbus Park was happening, not just in the church. Vietnamese restaurants and businesses began popping up down the street from Italian ones. In fact, remember Jenny's Italian restaurant? Well, you'll find a sign right under the Borelli name that says Kim Long, because it's now that Vietnamese market and restaurant opened by Serena Lee's parents, who were eager to live out the American dream just like the Italians when they first arrived.
My parents came from scratch, yes. It was the all-American dream because all they wanted it was freedom.
Some of the first Italian businesses helped get them closer to that freedom, hiring them as employees.
And we just kind of slowly tried to adapt with everybody, you know. It's because over the years, it's been all immigrants down here.
They taught each other about food.
Man, I didn't even like it.
Like it?
No.
Do you like it now?
Yes, I do.
Friendship.
He was like a brother to me because I worked side by side with him, you know.
And created memories.
I remember a lot of times there'd be stray dogs in the neighborhood, and out of the back door of the restaurant, they would feed the dogs, and we had two or three dogs called Meatball, you know.
I think I really love it. I'm loving it more as I grow older.
As they grow, history has shown many will leave this area if they haven't already, as they become successful Vietnamese Americans, much like the Italians did. And perhaps new immigrants will recycle through this special place called the North End, pushed up right against the Missouri River, with its rustic buildings full of history and ever-changing diversity.
If you're going to succeed, it takes a community that embraces your arrival, that says, we welcome you, we want you here.
And these are the hands that built America.
The Italians weren't the first group of immigrants to land in the area. Experts say there were Germans, Irish, Cubans, and African Americans. And now that there is new development happening in the area, there's really no guessing who will call it home years from now. Gia Vang, Fox 4 News, working for you.